2 weeks ago, we investigated a Christian rehabilitation centre in Perth accused of abusing vulnerable young women, yet received millions in funding from the Morrison Government. Now the centre has become an election issue, with Labor promising an urgent inquiry if it's elected next month.
I'm invested in nothing. I have my
stock. But today, the Prime Minister has not stopped the $4 million grant to the Esther Foundation. Even with more than 250 women who have come forward with claims of abuse, exorcisms and gay conversion.
The workers would pray over me, lay hands and attempt to exorcise demons that were causing my homosexuality.
I ran away from Esther House. I stood on a bridge in the city. And I jumped.
Now the federal opposition has raised the political stakes.
Well, it's just not good enough. I think people will want to know what the due diligence was that was conducted about the operations of this organisation before they received large sums of taxpayer money.
A Western Australian parliamentary committee will investigate the Esther Foundation and report back by December.
One of the challenges with claims of, for instance, gay conversion therapy is who's undertaking that sort of dubious work. It could be one of the issues that's looked at by the parliamentary committee. I know that was one of the reports that came forward.
For almost three decades, the Esther Foundation was run by Patricia Bevan and her now ex-husband, Rod Lavata, a reformed drug addict once jailed for fraud.
She would say that I needed deliverance, that there was a spirit, there was an evil spirit inside me that was basically stopping me, blocking me from God.
Tisha Harris was 18 when she was admitted to Esther House, a young alcoholic escaping domestic violence. She says she was shocked to find no trained therapists and that she was forced to attend church services run by Bevan.
People were falling down, people were shaking, and it was all in this, the name of God, like they got touched by God and things like that. But then when I didn't want to participate and I stood at the back, I was called to the front and pretty much humiliated. We were pressured to believe in God, and then felt like we weren't going to get better if we didn't.
Tisha claims she appeared to undergo such a transformation that Lavata held her up as a glowing example of the Foundation's work.
I felt like he exaggerated my story and I didn't feel comfortable with it. I felt like it was a lie, almost, like we were being deceitful.
In this newspaper article about a fundraising art auction, Tisha is quoted saying, "I came into Esther after trying to kill myself twice."
No, that wasn't accurate. I felt pressured to say that. I think to get funding, to get people to pull on the heartstrings, he used to say.
The Foundation certainly received plenty of support. In the late 2000s, then WA Premier Colin Barnett personally championed the Esther Foundation and signed off on a $3.9 million purchase of land for the centre. In 2010, when Barnett was still Premier, the WA Housing Authority purchased a convent to allow Esther to expand. Mr Barnett told the project, "My wife and I supported them at a personal level and then later provided government support for the Esther Foundation, but we were not aware of any ill treatment of the girls."
I don't think we've seen the half of where that money went, in my honest opinion.
Still no comment from the Prime Minister about the $4 million grant and his personal endorsement of the rehabilitation program.
I heard this week about someone as young as nine going into this facility, but also young women that were very, very vulnerable. They had mental health issues, drug and alcohol. They're at their most vulnerable, so we've got an extra layer of responsibility.
For its part, the Esther Foundation described the allegations as extremely distressing and said the program had undergone a complete overhaul. Patricia Bevan said, "I own the responsibilities of the mistakes and wrongs that were done on my watch."
I know that I'm really embarrassed, really ashamed of some of the things that happen in there. And I feel angry, to be honest. I feel quite angry.